Hello everyone, Rad here from Radko Tarot, and this is going to be general Tarot weekly reading for Virgo, May 21st to May 27, 2018. So with that being said, let's go directly to the spread, which is a four-card spread. The first one that shows up the topic of the week for Libra, that is going for Virgo, that is going to be the Nine of Swords. Then we do have the core of the situation here, that is going to be the Two of Pentacles. Then is the Star card as a challenge. And last but not least, we do have the guidance here. This is going to be the Nine of Cups. All right, so for Virgo, this this particular reading is just points that how can I place it, it doesn't look bad. First of all, I want to say it, even though we do have the Star as a challenge, and then we do have Nine of Swords as a you know, topic of the week for you, it doesn't look bad, because it's very difficult to explain. Let's say the expectations of what you are going to achieve are not going to be synchronized with the achieved, all right? So first of all, you will be very busy. That being said, it is very unlikely that you will have the time, the physical time for you to, which you want to have, all right, to spread yourself and to scatter yourself around into many different activities that you are contributing at. That being said, you will be into a situation where you have to juggle in between them and do the very best possible with the time you have into every single, you know, activity or field in your life that you are contributing, relationship or career, etc., etc., so you can reach the maximum result out of that. And the more you juggle, all right, and the more you scamper among those things, let's say in between your career and into your relationship, because you may need to put a lot of time into your career, but in the same time your relationship will demand a lot of time, and it is just as much time as we have, 24 hours per day, no more, all right? And as well, you need to rest, you know. So you may feel that both of those things are slipping off your fingers, and this is just an imaginary thought, all right? It is something that it isn't happening, but you are worrying that is going to happen. The Nine of Swords points that you are fearing of you know, the opinion of your boss, and that they, you think that they see in you not someone that they kind of like, you know, they expect. And same time goes for relationship. If it implants for a relationship that if you continue on the same performance, not giving the required time into it, your partner simply are going to leave you aside. And that, as we do have the star card into challenges, points that you may start losing hope that you will be able to sustain your position at this very moment. Very important to be said here, guys, is that this time it is just a prerequisite to some changes which are coming on into the future. The Two of Pentacles is always like this, a small minor changes that are happening until the right now in this very moment, which are prerequisite, as I said, for a bigger changes which are coming into the future. Very important to be said is that you should go day by day with not a strict plan how you're going to deal with everything that you do have. It is just, don't make your go-to list. Being flexible and being adaptable is the way how you can move on and how you can maximize upon your environment. As well, we have the Nine of Cups as a guidance card. The Nine of Cups points that you should contribute and you should attend only to things which actually gives you pleasure and which you like to do. Like, for example, just to give you an example, your partner may ask you to go on to dinner with a family friends, all right? But you don't like these family friends, you're totally not obliged to go into that particular dinner, and you can invest that time into do some additional work for your career. So tomorrow, you know, you have done your job and you can now invest more time into your relationship. This is what I'm trying to say, is that you are not obliged to to get yourself involved into everything which you have been proposed to. All right, the code of the good manner, it is not a code of being succumbed and following a certain code of conduct to a 100% maximum. But instead of that, you Virgos this week, guys, should take it a little bit more easy, all right? You should not believe into the doom and gloom. This is very important as well, because those who start believing into the doom and gloom, they will not be able to give the performance needed in order to face the big changes which are coming for you in the future. And on top of that, guys, as the Nine of Cups is pointing, is that you should invest more and more time into those things which makes you happy rather than those things which are chores for you. Nine of Swords at the end, as I said, it is about worrying, it is about anxiety, it is about fears. Face your fears, right? If you feel your position into your job threatened, go and talk with your boss. If you feel your position into your relationship threatened, then go and talk with your partner, etc., etc. Face your fears. That being said, this was your tarot reading, Virgo, for the upcoming week, May 21st to May 27th. I hope you guys enjoyed it and you liked it. And in case you're interested in a private reading with me, everything you need to know about it will be listed down there in the description of this video. Rad signing out now. See you next time. Bye.